I was younger, I never thought that I would come back to take over this farm from my dad. I think because the fear was that it was this humongous... I knew nothing about how the business worked. I knew how to sit in a tractor, and I knew how to put up a fence. I know that animals need food to survive, and this and that and the other thing. But had no idea how to go ahead and get a loan, what I needed to prepare for to get money from a bank. Even deciding what to do next, or how to do it financially, or what enterprise to take on. In the past, throughout my life, it would just been all those decisions would have been made on impulse or gut feeling. Now I have the ability to put it all on paper first and decide that it will work or not work. And if it doesn't work, even though I thought that it would work and I really wanted it to, I just have to pass on that because it doesn't make sense economically. Farm Beginnings taught me how to make decisions not based on purely the bottom line, like a business class in a college or some, any sort of institution would teach you. The main focus there would be, how do I make the most possible money with the least amount of work? Whether that means that you're doing a job that doesn't make you happy, you dread going to work every day, but you're making all this cash. So life is good. It's kind of the American dream, I think, is what we're taught all through high school and everywhere else. Farm Beginnings is very much opposite of that. The information that I was received came from people who are farming. They're all farm. They're not professors. They're not people with teaching degrees and doctorates in business. They're just people like me. People that were like me that decided that they wanted to farm, or they wanted to grow vegetables or run a CSA or convert their operation into a organic grass-fed, for instance, business. And these people didn't have anyone to help them but their, you know, family, friends, older generations that knew one way of farming, and that was industrialized commercial farming. But they went ahead anyway and decided that they would go forward in this new strange territory that they knew relatively nothing about. And without much help, real help. And they just tested things and decided along the way that, you know, this works, this doesn't work. And the way that was told to us from their perspective, really, that's what gives me the confidence to hear the stories of farmers or people, just city folk, that decided they wanted to buy an acreage and plant a bunch of vegetables, spend a whole lot of money, and then decide that, you know, then sell it, then figure out how to sell it once the vegetables are growing. And they did that, and that worked for them. So hearing a story like that makes me feel like, well, shoot, if they can do it, I can certainly do it too. I think that's the biggest part, is hearing real life stories about people succeeding. You don't get that in college. What you get in college is, this is how you do this, this is how you do that, this is the science behind that and this. Even if you were to go to an ag business school, I've not been to an ag business school. I do have a good friend that went to ag school, and he doesn't know anything about business. He knows what to feed his cows. He spent a lot of money on that education, whereas I spent a little bit of money to enroll myself in Farm Beginnings, and what I have now is a huge, huge network of contacts and people that are doing and thinking on the same lines that I am. So I can ask these people who are professionals in their field now, that's what they do. They're not maybe trained professional farmers, but that's what they do, that's what they know. I think that sort of information or education from those sort of people is far more valuable than sitting in a classroom being told what to think or what you should know. There's no real life hands-on learning. So everyone that came to talk to the class to lead the discussions, they all spoke a lot about the reason they made their decisions to either transfer their farming operations into a more sustainable one, or just some other sort of what they felt was more meaningful of a farming life. Everyone spoke of that, or even maybe a lot of people had jobs, you know, used to be accountants or bankers or whatever they were, that they just decided eventually that they wanted a little more excitement. They made the decision to go into farming or vegetable growing because they enjoyed the outdoors. And that meant more to them than making this much money. They were fine and even happier making half the amount of money with more freedom to do what they wanted to do. Your job is the outdoors. All the people that came to talk to us and teach our classes are all individuals who donated their time. They all felt a great need to give beginning aspiring farmers this information, this opportunity to do what they want. And they are all have made themselves available to any of us at any time to discuss our problems with, you know, or questions, just help us in any way they can. Not for money or anything, but that they feel that it's important, very important, that this way of life continues. I never thought that I could transition a large row cropping farming operation into something that's more fun and rewarding and sustainable, which now I believe is possible, and I and my brother and I are starting to do that with our asparagus and our beet planting over here, and we'll be converting a lot of the farm land, the row crop land, into pasture, so that we can graze and raise grass-fed beef and sheep and goats and whatever might come along. Farm beginnings opened my eyes to the fact that there's a heck of a lot more to life than just making a whole lot of money. It's very important to do what you love, and to wake up in the morning and be excited about this, all this work, all this way too much work you have to get done today. But I can still be excited about that because it's for me, first of all. I'm doing this for me and the land and our community. I'm hoping that everybody benefits from the decisions that I make rather than just my pocketbook. I feel like I have the tools available so that I'm not completely in the dark as to business and finance and projecting what the future might hold. A lot of farmers don't run their farms like businesses, I guess is what I'm trying to say. But the other very important thing that I now have is this gigantic list of resources. So we get this big book, notebook. It's got a little tab for each class, the 10 classes that we would attend. And in each, which spoke, you know, we didn't open the book every class and go page to page to page like a textbook. It was just kind of more of a nice, concise resource list that I still have and still refer to quite often. You know, there's the internet out there, or the, and there's this book, which has everything in it. I mean, just lists of resources of where to go to find the information you're looking for. For instance, grants. I've been looking into grants, and there must be 10 pages on grants and how they work and who offers them and what you have to do to get them. Which is very, very, very valuable to have. Before I started Farm Beginnings, I could count them on my hand, the number of resources I had for people anyway. You know, there are people in the community that would certainly help, but I was very unaware even before I started this class that there were people in this community that weren't just farming Monsanto crops and doing nothing more than growing fuel. Now I have a number of contacts, people that anything that I can think of wanting to do or am interested in learning how to do or what's available or even things that I've never thought of doing, all these people around now that I'm talking to and have relationships with are every day bringing me new ideas rising my confidence level to the point where I feel like I can pretty much do whatever I want, which is very, very good feeling. And I completely owe that to Farm Beginnings, 100%.